Let me, I'm going to backtrack slightly so that all of this makes sense. It may not right now. But earlier in the architecture diagram, I talked about deep bracing using SageMaker in the background. So what you're seeing here is the SageMaker interface. SageMaker is what we do for hosting, the training, the deploying, all of that work. is SageMaker. Now, in this case, as you build your model, so your reward function, and you train it, that outputs what's called a model artifact. You can find your artifact within S3, which is our storage service. You can download this artifact, and this is actually what you do when you load it into the vehicle. A little bit easier than this one button, but this is the idea, is you export your trained model to a USB stick, plug that USB stick in, and then off you go. But if you're really, you know, you really want to get your hands dirty, you can go into SageMaker, I will repeat the steps I did there, and you can find everything in a far more detail than the deep bracer interface will show you.
Yeah, just going a little bit deeper on that. So again, the reward functions is given to the RoboMaker that controls all the simulation, right? So if you really want to, you know what, the reward functions limited, or you want to hack around and say, let's say for example, I want to use the deep bracer, but instead of running the tracks, I want to identify other cars or do really fancy stuff, right? So in one hand, we have deep bracer, which abstracts away everything that you don't need to think about it. But then you can and really use the simulation to include your own infrastructure, not just for the reinforcement learning or machine learning, but also object detection and do all sorts of hacky stuff, right? So what Ricardo was showing you is just like, how do we make it, this car run a track? You want to do something else with the car, you could. But it will be just going to SageMaker and doing changing the way it plugs the reward function, so just simply ignoring the reward function altogether.
Even for running the track and only...
You could.
So this will help me break off the reinforcement learning preset model.
Yeah.
In which...
Definitely that, but I will not allow you to race the competition, because the racing in the competition is making sure that you have a solution for a reinforcement learning problem, right? But you could simply take a car and just, you know what, let me test different probabilistic models to see if it fits better than the actual reinforcement learning. And it will, because the difference is one, you have the driver, and reinforcement learning, you don't, right? It doesn't make sense. And you can mix and match. Again, going to the SageMaker notebook, you can mix and match that.
Okay, so whatever model we use, if we have a reward function that applies to the reinforcement learning parameter,
then you can purchase it. Yeah. But again, I'll say the key takeaway here is that deep racer want to abstract away all the complexity of reinforcement learning, so it's feasible for everyone. With basic CS skills, right? Just like, I know how to use a computer, and then maybe I know a little bit of a logic. You could use SageMaker to do a full-blown reinforcement learning or machine learning model, and then apply it to deep learning, or even print your own model and use a Epson board of Intel with an IoT, and then run your own car, right? So that would be the major takeaway theory. Did you have a question?
I just wanted to very quickly show you the insides of the deep racer. So, this is a little bit tough, but here, see your heat sink, right? In the bottom here, it's protected by a strap, but this is the small battery. This is the one that lasts you about 30 minutes. It's very easy to recharge. You would simply very easy to
charge, but not too important.
All right, so you unplug, and it's protected by a little strap. There you go. So it's protected by a little strap there, and you can then unplug that as you see fit. So that's really how easy it is. Your standard server motos are in place, just like your RC vehicles. In fact, the way Deep Racer initially started was from something called the RoboCar Rally. Right. RCV goes, customizing it and raise it. But we realized there's a lot of complexity involved in doing this. So we brought it into a simpler, easy to use consumer package. So you can buy a full deep racer for $250 on Amazon right now. For those that are competing, you don't have to buy anything. We will supply the deep racers for your different teams, and you'll be able to race.
And even you don't have, at the very end, you don't need a car.
You don't. Simulation.
Do you want to show the track?
Yes, that means hopefully it, speed. The internet was a little bit slow.
Not the simulation, just the track on the robo road maintenance side of
things.
Yeah, you don't need to see. But definitely there's two things here, right? So the Capstone project is one. Here you're going to use the deep racer, but also anything that you saw today. And we will work closely with you to make sure that when you succeed on your Capstone project and you learn something. And the second is the idea behind having a college deep racer league, Humber deep racer league, which would be like an event where you all get to form a team and race against each other, right? So nothing better than a little bit of a gamification, right? So it's like competition into the student campus to spice that up a couple of things. But as you can see here, RoboMaker is the behind the scenes, what powers all the simulation events, and you can see the car just going.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, and turning right.
It's learning the hard way, but What you're physically seeing is the vehicle running around the track. And this is our RoboMaker service in the back here. And you can see it here as well, although it's a little bit slow, but this shows you a real-time feed from the camera angle. So you can see it there, it's running off course, and it keeps going. So this is how you're virtually training a model. Of course, you can see in the left graph, the reward points and the way it's being accumulated.
Does that make sense?
Okay. Now, as you start working in Break, we're here working with you, helping you build the code. A lot more of this will make way more sense. We will guide you in writing the code and answering questions you may have. I'm sure you'll have some questions. All right. How much time do we have left?
Thank you. Thank you so much for a wonderful presentation. Are you all excited now?
Yeah.
All right, let's have some fun, okay? So, as I said, I'm looking for 10 groups of students to do the Capstone project on this. So if you are ready, talk to your Capstone instructor or the coordinator, sign up, and we'll have 10 groups. Once we have the 10 groups, I'm willing to provide all the resources you need. I already ordered the deep racer. It's up to AWS how soon they can deliver.
Yeah.
And I'll bring back this team. I hope if I have to, I'll bring back the team every other week. I know they are very busy. But
yeah, just
to coach you, to train you, to provide all the resources. Okay? So, sign up with your instructor. Okay? All right. Thank you. Thank you all for coming.
One follow-up question. How big can each group be? For the Capstone?
It's up to your Capstone professor.
Instructor. Yeah.
Talk to your instructor.
And again, I'm here now specifically.